لا إله إلا الله.
But in it is the title of the lecture. The hadith of Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu and Sahih, radiallahu anhu and Sahih, wherein the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِذَا أَحَبَّ اللَّهُ عَبْدًا نَادَى جِبْرِيلٌ فَيَقُولُ إِنِّي أُحِبُّ فُلَانًا فَأَحِبَّهُ فَيُحِبُّهُ جِبْرِيلٌ ثم ينادي في السماء أن الله يحب فلانا فأحبوه فيحبه أهل السماء ثم يوضع له القبول في الأرض. When Allah loves a slave, it doesn't end there. It could end there if Allah will, but no. Now listen to this. This is mind-boggling. This is too much. This hadith is too much. As in, it's so powerful, if we were to reflect on it, you should maybe faint. Please turn off the phones. When Allah loves a slave, He calls on Jibreel. Who's Jibreel? You know who Jibreel is? The greatest of the Malaika, as far as Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah. The one whom when the Prophet saw, he fainted alayhi salatu wasalam, because of his wings had covered the horizon. Jibreel, the angel who's responsible for the most virtuous thing, which is conveying the revelation from Allah to the messengers of Allah. Jibreel, and what do you know about Jibreel? Allah said, whoever is adu, whoever is an enemy to Jibreel, then Allah is the enemy to the disbelievers. Allah defended Jibreel in the Quran. Jibreel, the one who took the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in Al-Isra Al-Mi'raj, in the ascension to the heavens. Jibreel, the malak which we don't know what to say about, because of his honor and his virtue in the sight of Allah. Allah will call on him to share with him the love which he has for you. Allah doesn't need to do this. He could not do this, but Allah likes to do this. So he does it. He says, I love Fulan. Now I want you to think that Fulan is you. Whatever your name is, Ahmad, Mayrook, whatever your name is. Imagine Allah in the above the heavens, above the throne, in His greatness and His majesty, which is beyond our human comprehension, calls out to Jibreel to inform him that he loves you. And then only that. فَأَحِبَّهُ, then he commands Jibreel to love you also. So Jibreel now loves you. Allah and Jibreel love you. But it doesn't end there. Jibreel then will call upon the inhabitants of the Sama. Who are they? All the Malaika. How many? We can't even count. Trillions and trillions of Malaika which Allah created beyond our, again, human comprehension. All of them are commanded simultaneously to love you. First Jibreel says, Allah loves Fulan, so now you have to love him. Then all of the angels in the heavens love you. Then Allah will place acceptance for you on earth. So people will love you. Not everyone. You may be saying, why do I have enemies? People who love the Sunnah will love you. The people who love Allah and His Messenger will love you. The people who are upon the correct aqidah and methodology will love you. Other people may hate you because of a problem in them, not because of a problem in you. Because you may say, well, this fasiq, this evil, disobedient person doesn't love me. Don't expect him to love you. He loves people like himself. Who will love you? Righteous people. Righteous people. They don't know why. They don't even know why. You've never even given them a dollar or a rial or a pound. You've never done anything for them. Maybe you scream at them. Maybe you do other things. It's Allah. Why? Because Allah had loved you first. Then Jibreel had loved you first. Then the Malaika loved you afterwards. Then Allah put acceptance for you on earth. So people have no choice but to love you. We ask Allah to make us among them. Now what better than that? What else do you want? What else do you want? What? If you're a person whom Allah loves, in every movement you go, you do, You pray, you sleep, you whatever you do, you are among those whom Allah loves and Jibreel loves and the angel loves. What else do you want, ya akhi? You're guaranteed success in this life and in the life to come. Guaranteed. No way Allah will punish you. No way. No way Allah will punish someone whom He loves. But the hadith doesn't stop. The hadith has a very saddening continuation, which we should seek refuge with Allah from. وَإِذَا أَبْغَضَ عَبْدًا And if Allah hates a slave, He also calls on Jibreel. And He informs Jibreel that He hates this person. So He will command Jibreel to hate this person. Then Jibreel will tell the angels to hate this person. Then Allah will put hatred for him on earth. La ilaha illallah. Imagine you walking upon the planet, the face of the earth which Allah created, while Allah hates you, and the angels hate you, and Jibreel hates you, and the righteous people hate you. What a sad state for a human being. And ikhwan, we could be one of those as well. If you are prideful, arrogant, you are qualified for this hatred, because Allah does not love kulla mutakabbirin jabbar. Allah does not love the arrogant, the prideful. If you go against the sunnah, then Allah does not love those who go against the sunnah. If you don't observe taqwa, and you don't observe ihsan, and you don't observe tawbah and tatahur, then again we are disqualified. If you, many things which we can mention, many things which will bring about Allah's hatred and deprive us of Allah's love. It's a very sensitive situation, meaning right now, you have to be one of these two. Either Allah loves you or He doesn't. But there's always good news even for those people whom we can be amongst. It's not too late because you're alive. It's not too late because it's Ramadan. It's not too late because you're breathing. Even if you led a life of someone who had attained Allah's hatred, if you were to return to Allah, then Allah will love you and be happier. He will be so happy with your tawbah than a man who lost his mount in the desert, upon it was his food and his drink, and then he waited under a tree for death. And all of a sudden he opened his eyes and he sees his camel or his horse or whatever that was right in front of him. And he gets so happy, he said, Allahumma anta abdi wa ana rabbuka. Oh Allah, you are my slave and I am your Lord. Kufr. He said his statement of kufr, but the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, akhta'a min shiddati al-farah. He made a mistake because he's so happy. You know when you're so happy that you may say things against what you want to say? When you're so happy that you just, you know, you say words that mean nothing to anyone? Allah is happier when you return to Him than that person. What else do we want? For how long are we going to stay away from Allah? For how long are we going to lead the life of the heedless? For how long are we going to go against the sunnah? What are you waiting for? Death? Death. حَتَّى إِذَا جَاءَ أَحَدَهُمُ الْمَوْتِ قَالَ رَبِّ ارْجِعُونَ لَعَلِّي أَعْمَلُ صَالِحًا فِي مَا تَرَكْتِ كَلَّا. Until when death comes to one of them, you say, oh Allah, allow me to return so that I may do good in that which I left behind. And it will be said to him, no. It's only a word. إِنَّهَا كَلِمَةٌ هُوَ قَائِلُهَا. It's nothing but a wish and a word he will have. It will not be fulfilled. Let us not wait for death, ya akhwan. If each one of us here, by Allah, if each one of us here acted upon the sunnah, lived according to the sunnah, and invited people to the sunnah, and enjoyed what is good, and forbade what is evil, wallah, we will make a major change in the city in which we live. And if Muslims, youngest all over the world, had that same attitude, then we will change the condition of the whole ummah. So no enemy can come and play games with us. We will squash them, all of them, because Allah will defend. إِن تَنْصُرُ اللَّهِ يَنْصُرْكُمْ وَيُثَبِّتْ أَقْدَامَكُمْ. If you aid Allah's deen, Allah will aid you and will keep your feet firm. But we don't even live according to the sunnah, let alone be given victory over the enemies. So we're being humiliated and everywhere we go in the world. So let us make that change. Now that Ramadan is here, now that you've been given this sudden inclination towards good. If we don't succeed, if we don't take advantage of this month, wallahi, we are losers. If Ramadan ends and you are the same way you were before Ramadan began, then one of us is a loser. If we don't return to Allah after Ramadan, then we are losers as well. So tonight, bi-ithnillah, always on our mind, attaining Allah's love, acquiring Allah's love, fetching for the sunnah, and acting upon it whenever we are able to do so. If you do this, then you can expect the unexpected. You can see from Allah's facilitation and mercy and love and things with compassion that words cannot even begin to describe. And if you don't believe me, and you don't have to believe me, read the stories of the Salaf. Read the biographies of the Sahaba. Read Musaab bin Umayr. Read Ali bin Abi Talib. Read Abu Bakr as-Siddiq. Read all of the Sahaba and the Tabi'een and the Ulama. Wallahi, some of them led lives which we could never even begin to deal with. And they were the happiest people on earth. Allah guided them in every affair. And I always quote Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah because he is the most classical example. A man who died in prison for fatwa, for the deen of Allah. A man who died in prison telling the people, ما يصنع أعدائي بي? What will my enemies do to me? My garden, my Jannah, بستاني في صدري, it's in my chest. They can handcuff your arms, but they cannot handcuff your heart. They can put you in by yourself in a cell, but they cannot keep you away from Allah. They cannot keep you from Allah. This was the iman of this man, whom Allah Azza wa Jal guided until he died, until today. Wallahi, the people of the Sunnah love Shaykh al-Islam more than their fathers. They love him, they don't even know why. Never seen him, never met him, never nothing. Just you say Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah, and you say, La ilaha illallah, radiyallahu anhu, rahimahullah, you love him, you don't know why, you don't even know what to say. And any scholar upon the Sunnah, when we speak of Shaykh bin Baz, Shaykh bin Uthaymeen, Shaykh Albani, wallah, in the hearts of the people of Sunnah, there's love which you cannot even begin to express. Why? Because what we know of them is that they lived according to the Sunnah and they taught to the people. You do the same, you will get the same privilege. You will lead the life of the content, and you will die the life of the content, and you will be resurrected content, and you will enjoy Jannah in the company of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam for eternity. Do not disqualify yourself from the company of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam fil firdaws al a'la because of some mundane lowly things. وَمَنْ يُطِعِ اللَّهَ وَالرَّسُولَ فَأُولَٰئِكَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ مِنَ النَّبِيِّينَ وَالصِّدِّقِينَ وَالشُّهَدَاءِ وَالصَّالِحِينَ وَحَسُنَ أُولَٰئِكَ رَفِيقًا. If you obey Allah and His Messenger, this is what will you be in the company of those whom Allah has bestowed His favors upon from among the prophets, on top of them the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Al-mar'u ma'a man ahab. The man will be in the company of the one whom he loves. You love the Messenger of Allah, that means you must follow him. If you follow him, you will be with him in Jannah. Why? This is Fadlullah yu'tihi man yasha. This is the bounty of Allah. He gives it to whosoever He wills. No one can come and say, you're going to be with the Messenger of Allah. Yes, you. Because Allah wants it to be this way. How? If you do the necessary. If you have lived by the Sunnah and acquired Allah's love. So this should be the mentality of the Muslim in his life. Striving and striving until you meet Allah. And if we do so, then we have the best assumption about Allah Azza wa Jal, that He will fulfill His promise, and He will give us what we long for, and He will make us enjoy looking at His face subhanahu wa ta'ala in Jannah, and He will make us among those whom He will honor and bless in this life and in life to come. Verily He is able to do all things. Wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa man tabi'ahum bi ihsanin.
Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim.
In the name of Allah, the absolutely merciful, the especially merciful.
Shuru Allah ke naam se, jo bada meherban, nihayat rahim wala hai.
Wala taqfu ma laysa laka bihi ilm, inna as-sam'a wal-basara wal-fu'ada kullu ulai ذَٰلِكَ كَانَ عَنْهُ مَسْئُولًا.
And do not follow that of which you have no knowledge. Verily, the hearing and the sight and the heart, of each of those you will be questioned.
اور اے بندے جس چیز کا تجھے علم نہیں اس کے پیچھے نہ پڑ کہ کان اور آنکھ اور دل ان سب جوارے سے ضرور باز پرس ہوگی.
ربنا رب القلوب وهو علام الغيوب في الشروق وفي الغروب نوره يهدي العصار.